he got to the seat of the judge was already smiling. Because the words that were released gladdened the heart of who? Of the judge. You know, a child, thank God for children and those who have them. A child may offend the father. And actually, an offense has been committed. And the child coming from a distance, see the countenance of the father, will be on, will even kneel down and say, "Daddy, you know I have sinned. I know I have offended you. Oh, God, where do I go now? Where do I start from? Please, give me another chance. I will not do it again." But before the child came, the father had a cane behind to say, "As soon as this child comes, I'm going to cane him. He will know me today as the father." But by the words of mouth, positive words, what happened? The child is delivered. May you be delivered by positive words in Jesus' name. In Proverbs 18:21, it says, "Death and life are in the power of the tongue. And they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof." Death and life, well, are in the power of the tongue. Look at this, not just being alive physically or dying physically. Everything you handle in life, by the power of your tongue, can live or can die. Amen. I want us to develop the habit of speaking positive words. What did I say? Develop the habit of what? Speaking positive words to your neighbor, to your husband, to your wife, to people around you. You know, a word, a positive answer, a soft answer will turn away wrath, anger. I am not better than you. You are not better than me. But we are what we are by the grace of God. So in relationship, let your word what be positive. Say, look, a soft answer turneth away what wrath. You know, there are people, I may just say, they are pathologically angry. When you talk, you say, "Leave me alone." And because he hasn't leave me alone, people run away from him. Amen. But when you speak positive words, anger is quenched. Proverbs chapter 15, verse 1 and 2. "A soft answer turneth away wrath, but grievous words stir up anger." A soft answer. May you have the grace to give a soft answer in Jesus' name. Don't tell anybody off and say nothing will happen. When you do that, something happens in the realm of the spirit. The soul is offended. And a wounded soul is like a wounded lion. He fights back and brings confusion and disagreement. But we as brethren, we as carrier of Christ, let our words be soft and friendly. Let what? Our words be soft and friendly. There are many places you cannot go if your words are hard, but when they are soft, there is no barrier There's no barricade that you cannot cross. Because soft and friendly words will open the door for you. Anywhere, anytime, any place. The tongue of the wise useth knowledge aright. But the mouth of fools poureth out foolishness. I've just read Proverbs 15, verse 1 and 2. Let me read it again. A soft answer turneth away wrath, but grievous words stir up anger. The tongue of the wise useth knowledge aright, but the mouth of fools poureth out what? Foolishness. Don't be hasty with your mouth to say anything, but if you want to say, let it be soft and friendly. Even in the midst of pain and anguish and anger and annoyance, let your words be few and let your words be soft. Let your words what? Be few and let them be soft. Because the words that you speak into the air, they are very difficult to withdraw. A man, a personality or an individual, at the time of anguish, the words that you speak to such a one, they are almost indelible in that person's life. They can wound, but they can also heal. May God give you healing words in Jesus' name. Proverbs 15:23. A man hath joy by the answer of his mouth, and a word spoken in due season, how good is it? When you speak good words in any season, they gladden the heart. I remember many years back, a lady did school set and failed almost all the subjects. And that was not the nature of their family. Their family was a family of A1s. But this particular one, this school said, and got almost F9. And the words that they spoke to her, they were so grievous. But somebody else came and told her, don't worry, you can make it. Because you are down does not mean you cannot rise. This is just a step, this is just a challenge in your life. Those words kept ringing in her heart all as many, many years as I can remember. And the negative words did not disappear from her heart. May you have the wisdom to give positive words, positive speeches in adverse situations in Jesus' name. You know, there are pains that are easy to heal, but words will heal. Amen. Words heal. Words heal. The word that you speak, they heal. Number two, words can greatly affect the destiny of a man and the destiny of a nation. Just the word that you speak can affect your destiny, can affect the destiny of a nation. You know, you pray for a destiny partner, isn't it? Because there's somebody who must take you across the bridge. And if by adventure you are not endowed with divine wisdom, when your destiny partner comes, the word that you speak will distance that destiny partner from you. And what you have been praying for all the years, because of the uncircumcision of your heart, you drive such a person away, that the blessings will be far from you. Say, God forbid. In 2 Chronicles chapter 10, chose a nation whose destiny was changed because of words. Second Chronicles chapter 10, verse 1 to 19. I will read it very quickly, but let me tell you in summary what happened. Rehoboam was king, and his father ruled with iron hand. And people ran away from his father. But when they heard that he had become king and the father had died, they met him and said, "Look, we have come to you. Befriend us. Don't rule us like your father did." He said, "If you come back, he will give them answer." What did he do? He consulted with the elders. And the elders told him, "Look, these people, as they have come, speak to them soft words." Speak what to them? What? Soft words. "That they may stay with you." He said, "Okay." Then he consulted the young men who did not have the experience of life. And the young man told him, I said, "Look, as they have come, tell them that you are going to afflict them the more. That you are going to handle them stronger than your father handled them. And you are going to be hard on them." He listened to the counsel of what? Of the young men. And thereafter, what did he do? He told the people that, "Look, my father handled you this way, I'm going to be harsher." And the people said, "Okay, we leave you. We are going to be on our own." And they left him, and his kingdom crumbled. Why? Because of what? Harsh words. A kingdom is built by soft words of wisdom. But a house is destroyed by harsh words. Let your words be few and what? And friendly, so that which you have built may remain. Say amen. So that which you have built what? Shall remain. That is 2 Chronicles chapter 10, verse 1 to 19. Let me quickly read it. "And Rehoboam went to Shechem, for to Shechem all Israel come to make him king. And it came to pass, when Jeroboam, the son of Nebat, who was in Egypt, whither he had fled from the presence of Solomon the king, because Solomon was harsh on him. So Jeroboam ran away. He heard that Rehoboam was now king. So he returned back. And they sent and called him. So Jeroboam and all Israel came and spake to Rehoboam, saying, 'Thy father made our yoke grievous. Now therefore is thou what somewhat the grievous attitude of thy father, and his heavy yoke that he put upon us, and we will serve thee.'" They came to him and said, "Look, the yoke of your father was heavy upon us, but we have come to you. Remove this body from us, we will serve you." Now, "And he said unto them, 'Come again unto me after 3 days.' And the people departed." They came with a good intention because they went to remain with him. There are people in your life that will help you build. There are people in your life that will expand your kingdom. May you receive wisdom to retain them in Jesus' name. Are you hearing me? Those at the back, Sam, are you hearing? Okay, God bless you. And King Rehoboam took counsel with the old men that had stood before Solomon his father while he yet lived, saying, What counsel give ye me to return answer to these people? And they said unto him, saying, if thou be kind to these people and please them. What did he say? If you are kind to these people and you please them, and speak good words to them, they will be thy servants, what? Forever. If you want to speak good words to them, develop the attitude of speaking good words to people. Don't speak offensive words. No matter the situation you find yourself, may you have the spirit of restraint in Jesus' name. In verse 8, but he took the counsel which the old men gave him, and took counsel with the young men that were brought up with him, that stood before him. And he said unto them, what advice give ye that we may return answer to these people which have spoken to me, saying, is somewhat the yoke that thy father had put on us? And the young men that were brought up with him spake unto him, saying, thus shall thou answer the people that spake to thee, saying, thy father made a yoke heavy, but thou somewhat lighter for all. Thus shall thou say to them, my little finger shall be thicker than my father's loin. He said, his yoke was going to be what? Stronger. At the end of it all, they departed from him, and his kingdom crumbled. May God give you the wisdom to build in Jesus' name. See, number three, words. Wise words are health and life. The word that you speak to somebody, their health and what? And their life. Because the word that you minister, they bring healing. In Proverbs chapter 10, verse 11a, the mouth of a righteous man is a well of life. When somebody is ill or overtaken by a form of ailment, what is your duty as a Christian? Go and pray for the person and encourage the person to have faith. You know, a lot of people, when they hear that somebody is sick, they say, yes, they knew the person would be sick. It's the sin that he committed that is causing, making him sick. He's an evil man. And they even say to the face of the person, say, if because you are sick, you are evil, we have been talking to you, you will not hear. Those ones do not heal. Praise the Lord. The words that you speak should bring life to people. To what? To bring life to them. In Proverbs chapter 12, verse 18b, he said, the tongue of the wise is health. The tongue of what? Of the wise is health. What you say to somebody is able to heal such a one. Number three, always speak the right thing at the right time. Always what? Speak the right thing at the right time. As a wise master builder, before you open your mouth, make sure whatever you are going to say is appropriate for that situation and that circumstance. Proverbs chapter 10, verse 32a. The lips of the righteous know what is acceptable. Know what to say at the right time. If you don't know what to say, keep quiet. Because if you say what is wrong at the right time, you can wound a soul. The lip of the righteous knows what is acceptable. In Proverbs 25, verse 11, the word fitly spoken is like apples of gold in pitchers of silver. Every word that you say at the correct time is able to heal. The Bible says it's like an apple of gold in pitchers of silver. Receive the grace to speak the proper word in Jesus' name. You know, you can scatter a whole house. A husband or a wife can destroy the family that we have been building just by one sentence, because wisdom was not consulted. In everything, guide your mouth with wisdom. Speak the right word at the right time. I want to counsel you. Always speak encouraging words, even to your children, to your husband, to your wife, to your friend. Words of encouragement can heal. It will strengthen the relationship between you and strengthen the relationship of the other. Hear me well. A mouth, the mouth of a destroyer, can pull down a whole house in one day just by one sentence, by one statement. Don't consult anger before you speak. If you are angry, anger is a spirit. If you can't cast it off, keep quiet. Don't ever open your mouth when you are angry, because there are words that can come out of your mouth that will destroy the Tower of Babel, a high tower. But you see, words of encouragement will always be in Isaiah. Isaiah 35. Verse 3 to 4. Isaiah 35. Verse 3 to 4. Strengthen ye the weak hands and confirm the feeble knees. By your words, let your word be salty. Say to them that are of fearful heart, be strong. Oh, hallelujah. Say to them that what? Of a fearful heart, say, be strong. Fear not. Behold, your God will come with vengeance. Even God, with a recompense, He will come and save you. That is the word of encouragement you and I should say. Always encourage, say encouraging what will strengthen one another. Let me read that verse 4 again. He said, say to them that of a fearful heart, be strong. Tell your neighbor, be strong. And fear not. Behold, your God will come with vengeance. Even God with a recompense, He will come and save you. Because He's able to deliver. Amen. It's not over until it's over. And when it's over, you have won. Because God will never fail you. Let us encourage one another in this race. Let us say, look, say to them that of fearful heart, whatever you fear, today it shall not come upon you in Jesus' name. If you fear death, it's a lie. Death will not come. Because He died for you that you may live. If you fear failure, you will never fail. Because he meant you to be on top, not below. I said this word of encouragement to you in Jesus' name. Don't look at the situation of the country and then condemn yourself. Look at heaven. In the midst of pain, in the midst of anguish, people are still existing and living well. When there was hunger and famine in the land, in the land of Goshen, there was plenty of everything because the Lord was with them. And I make bold to say to you, the Lord is with you. Encourage yourself, encourage one another. The Lord is with us. Nothing will happen to us without the knowledge of God. And the Bible says, God loves us. He will do for us what man cannot do. Job chapter 4, verse 4. Thy words are upholding him that was falling, and thou hast strengthened the feeble knees. Job 4, 4. Let your words always strengthen the feeble knees. As many as are falling, strengthen them. Amen. We have a God that is able, more than able, to deliver, to save, to give you everything that pertains unto what godliness and righteousness. Amen. Encourage yourself and encourage one another. It is not dark, it is bright. Amen. What it is what? Not dark, it is what? It's bright. The power of positive word. Speak it to yourself and speak it to your neighbor. Speak and talk about the words of God. What did I say? Speak and talk about the words of God. That's number four. Speak and what? Talk about the word of God. In Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 6 and 7. Every time, talk about the word of God. The word of God is able to refresh you. The Bible says the word of God is powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword. Whatever is in your life, whatever is in the life of your neighbor, the word that you speak can change it. Deuteronomy chapter 6 verse 6 says, and this word which I command thee this day shall be in thy heart. Shall what? Be in thy heart. And thou shalt teach them diligently unto thy children, and shalt talk of them when thou sittest in thy house, when thou walkest in by the way, when thou lie down, when thou risest up. Let the word of God always come out of your mouth. In every adversity, in every situation, encourage one another. Praise the Lord. And encourage yourself too. By the word of God, we faileth not. You see, the Bible says, this word of God is perfect. The word of God is the law of God. In Psalm 19, verse 7 to 8. Psalm 19, verse 7 to 8. The law of the Lord is what? Is perfect. The word of God is perfect. When the Bible says something is perfect, it is what? Is perfect. The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. Speak the word of God now and again to yourself and to one another. There is power in positive speech. When your body is fretting, Don't say you are sick. You are not sick. You have been threatened. You reject every form of sickness. Reject every form of infirmity, because the words that you speak, that is what you eat. Oh, hallelujah. Always be positive by your word. Be positive by your speech. And because the word that you speak is powerful, it shall come to pass. He said, the law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. Psalm 19, 7 to 9, let me read it again. The law of the Lord is what? Is perfect. Is what? Perfect. Converting the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure, making wise the simple. Making what? Wise the simple. Remember, you as a child of God, you are an oracle of God. And as an oracle, you speak the word of God. Speak the word as what? As an oracle of God. The word that you speak are what? Powerful. Amen. James counseled us. He said, look, what the tongue, that is a powerful tool. It's just like the governor of a ship that controls the ship. So every word that you speak that comes out of your mouth directs your life, directs situations. It is with your mouth that you curse. It's with your mouth that you bless. Let your mouth be a vessel of blessing. Let your mouth be a vessel of blessing. Let your mouth be a vessel of blessing. In the name of Jesus. And cultivate that habit. Don't curse anyone. Curse the devil. What did I say? Curse the devil, because the devil is already cursed. So you are only agreeing with God. Whatever the situation, let blessings emanate from your mouth. In John chapter 6. Verse 63. John 6. It is the spirit that quickeneth. The flesh profiteth nothing. The word that I speak unto you, they are what? They are spirit and they are life. Let your word quicken men. Give them hope and aspiration. Let your word bring light to men, even in the midst of darkness. God, by the word of your mouth, shall change their destiny. Say amen. Your words have power. He said, it is the spirit that quickeneth, and that the word that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. The word of God that comes out of your mouth, let it be positive. Let it be encouraging. When you speak God's encouraging word to the soul of a man who is already downcast, he makes a U-turn. He changes the circumstances of his life. He gives him a different perspective of who he is and what he is in Christ. And that different perspective is the proper perspective. Whatever situation you are passing through today is just a temporary one. Say amen. The Bible says it shall come to pass. What? It shall come to pass. And when it comes to pass, the fullness of the benefit of God shall come into your life. In the name of Jesus. You encourage yourself. It's not a time to be downcast. The will of God shall be done in your life. In the name of Jesus. The will of God, what? Shall be done in your life in the name of Jesus. always have that positive attitude. We are not them that turn back. We prepare our life by spoken words. By what? By spoken words. Remember, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. Have a positive mind in all situations of life. You are down today, does not mean that you'll be down forever. Amen. You see, there is no road without a mountain. There is no road without a valley. There is no bush without thorns. When you are passing through a valley, always look up. There's a hill in front of you. What made that valley a valley is because of the hill that are on both sides, isn't it? And you will climb to the mountaintop in Jesus' name. The word of God that you speak is an encourager, his spirit and his life. Believe God's word and speak it to every situation of your life. And that word, every mountain in your life, what shall bow? Moses, the children of Israel cried. They look at the Red Sea. We wish we would have gone back to Egypt. And Moses heard the word of God. He said, Moses, why criest thou unto me? What is in your hand? He said, the rod. That was the voice of God. That was the word of God. And Moses acted by the voice of God, by the word of God. By the word of God, today, every mountain that you saw yesterday, you will see no more forever in Jesus' name. They will skip like ram. The word, positive word that you speak are powerful. The word of God that you speak is powerful. It's sharper than any two-edged sword. There's nothing that can contend with the word of God and win. Speak to one another in psalms, in songs. Don't gather together and tell tales of woes. We are testifiers of the victory and the magnanimity and the power of our God. That is what we speak in the midst of the congregation of the people of God. I want you to develop the attitude of speaking positive words. It is well with you. It is well with you. And no matter the situation, don't give up hope. We are people with hope. Whatever situation you find yourself as a child of God, God was there before you got there. Because he knows the end from the beginning. And when you get to such a place, let positive words come out of your mouth. When a friend or a brother is in a difficult situation, let positive words work. Come out of your mouth. Oh, hallelujah. Let what? But he said, the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are what? They are life. The word that you speak. Finally, have a sense of humor. Be able to laugh at every situation. Have a sense of humor. Many years back, I remember in the foundation of Pentecostalism, the Christians, the then Christians, the word being born again was not invoked. They said we have a new life. They used to call them new lifers. And one of the characteristics of the new life was that they never used to smile. They tightened their faces. And because our people ran away from them, I'm not condemning them, but that was the level of their understanding. They were men of one trouser, one shirt. But that belief helped them up to today. I'm not condemning them, but I want you to have a sense of humor and be able to laugh at situations. Tell your neighbor, have a merry heart. Say, have a merry heart. Have a merry heart. Christianity is not bondage. Christianity is freedom. Freedom of spirit. Not freedom to behave anyhow, because you don't have a life of your own. The life you live is the life of Christ. The freedom you have is the freedom of God. As a child of God, you cannot behave anyhow. You have to behave according to the word of God. Because you don't have any freedom. The freedom you have is what? Belongs to God. Oh, hallelujah. As a child of God, you are not free to do anything. You are only free to do the counsel of God. And thereunto, you stick yourself unto it. But have a sense of what? Of humor. Be able to laugh at situations. Be able to smile to one another. When you tighten your face, it's not a sign of holiness. Let your countenance be fair. Let it have a good countenance towards all men, so that your friendly attitude will radiate the beauty of Christ that is in you. In Proverbs 17:22. A merry heart doeth good. Like what? Like a medicine. But a broken spirit dried up bones. Be merry in your heart. Amen. Let joy overwhelm you. When you are sad, God will not be able to pray. But when the joy of the Lord overwhelms you, you see the beauty of God. You see what? The beauty of God. He said, a merry heart doeth good like medicine. It heals. But a broken spirit dried up bones. Psalm 126, verse 2. Let me start from verse 1. He said, when the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, we were like them, what? That dream. Your captivity has been turned around. Say amen. Your captivity has been turned around. What you are seeing or perceiving is a shadow, and it will soon disappear. Our captivity has been turned around. We are not longer under the grip of the devil. The devil may like, because you see, the devil, and I'm not trying to eulogize the devil, but the devil is a schemer. But in you, it is the spirit of God which is greater than the scheming attitude of the devil. God has given you everything it takes to cage the devil, to bind the devil, and what? And cast him out of your life. Amen. He said, when the Lord had turned again the captivity of Zion, we were like them that dream. Then our mouth filled with what? With laughter. Receive that laughter in Jesus' name. He said, then was our mouth filled with laughter, and our tongue with singing. Then said they among the heathen, the Lord had done great things for them. Say amen. The Lord has done great things for you. You show it by your attitude, by joyful living. Let your mouth be filled with laughter. Let your tongue be full of singing. Sing psalms unto God. Don't gossip. Don't murmur. Let your life be a life of praise and worship. Let your life be a life of what? Praise and what? And worship. Let your life be a life of what? Praise and worship. Let me be joyful. Don't don't be lugubrious. Don't be deceived as if you are carrying the whole world on your head. It's not true. Christ is carrying the world on your head, on his head, on your behalf, that your joy might be full. I say rejoice. And again, I say what? Rejoice. For God has done great and mighty things for us. Walk in the liberty of the Spirit. Don't be restrained. Walk in the liberty of the Spirit. Wherewith God has purchased for us everything that pertaineth unto life and godliness. Receive joy. Receive gladness. Receive joy. Receive gladness. Receive what? Joy and what? And gladness. Joy in your heart. The joy of the Lord. Gladness and joy in serving the Lord. Because it's a privilege for God to give you the opportunity to serve Him. In conclusion, let us continue to speak encouraging words and strengthen one another in the Lord. Encouraging words, encourage yourself, encourage one another. Let us strengthen ourselves. Let us strengthen the brother. As many as are falling, strengthen them. And you don't fall. Even if you are falling, encourage yourself. You are not the first to fall, and God's hand is stretched forth to bring you up. Even if you fall 7 times, rise up and continue on the race. Because the Lord God is a merciful God. He said His mercy endureth what? Forever. Genesis 50. Verse 21b. Joseph, despite all that his brothers did to him, he had this to say. Genesis 50:21b. And he comforted them and spake kindly unto them. Whatever anybody has done to you, speak the words of comfort and be kind unto such a one. The Bible said, be kindly affectionate one to another. Speak the word of comfort. Encourage one another. Positive words. Our better days are here. Say amen. Our better days are here. Get into them. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. Ask God. Bow down your head, please, and ask God to give you the grace to speak positive words to your life and to everyone around you. Ask God to give you the grace to give soft answer to as many as will inquire of you. Ask God for the grace to speak the right word at the proper time. That you will not speak out of anger or out of vexation. Ask God to strengthen you and also to strengthen others. Because the journey is far, but the Lord is on our side. Let the joy of the Lord overwhelm you. Ask God to give the joy of the Lord, the joy of service. That when you are coming to church, you are glad. Samuel says, I was glad when they said, let us go to the house of the Lord. Let the joy of the Lord overwhelm you in all circumstances in the name of Jesus. Let's stand up, please. Lift up your right hand. I will make my life your dwelling place. I will build your throne in my heart. Come, Father, come.